And we have Reverend Anna and practitioner. I always want to say facilitator, but it's practitioner Shelley with us. So today we have a special treat, so welcome. Yay! Also a big thank you to Marilyn this morning for our pre-service music. And as you know, it is prayers of the candles here. So at any time here this morning, feel free to come up and light a candle, put a name on the board. The board will come up though during our meditation song so that our practitioner can pray for those names on our list for our peoples. Real quick, we have Wednesday night service will be drumming circle. Woo! Nina's like got the motion. There you go. And then, of course, next Sunday, CSL Outdoor Work Day following fellowship.
Yes, I'm looking forward to it. All the fun is at no cost. So there will be various levels of physical exertion, so you don't have to worry about that. And no kidding, it is a lot of fun. So you can bring work clothes, gloves, whatever you might like to do, and I'm looking forward to it.
Super, thank you. And of course, we want you to mark your calendars because Wednesday, May 15th, we will have a Taizé service with Erica Sati. Is her name right? Great. And Cheese from Mile High. See, I was listening. Right? So it's a little bit of a change up because it's the 15th. So just to let you know that. And then, of course, date nights are coming up to be reinstated this summer. So we're going to start the first date night, May 31st. 7 p.m. outdoors in under our beautiful tree, homemade ice cream. Is that a Nancy Hutto ice cream?
Ooh.
Yes. Right? Yay. Okay.
Nancy.
Yeah, it's our favorite. If you haven't had it, it's wonderful. And then we will listen to the Solar Brothers Band with Roy and Brenda and Paul Frazier. So our very own. So lots of fun things. Make sure you get your information off the table if you need anything. So let us center in and take a deep breath. And we will speak our purpose statement together. As an intentional spiritual community, the purpose of CSL is to be a living environment for individuals to realize that we are all unique emanations of God, the love intelligence governing the universe. We embody the truth of our oneness with God, and we consciously practice this truth in our everyday life. Through the exploration of new thought and ageless wisdom and the energy of unconditional love, we are dedicated to individual transformation and to being a beneficial presence in the world.
In this sacred and special moment, we drop into our hearts as we truly move to that quiet space within. That space where we know that God is right here where we are. Where we feel the impress of that divine presence in our being. And we know that we are surrounded and filled with the light and the love of the divine. I know that there's a wisdom and a deep intelligence that is alive in all things right now, that is seeking the highest and the best for each one of us. We see this in the beauty all around us, and it reminds us of the beauty that's within us. And I know that we've been called to this service today to open our hearts, to feel the support and the love in this room from each person that's present. I know that Reverend Anna's talk is blessed, and I know that each person here will experience it in their own unique way and hear exactly what they came here to hear. I know that we're also blessed today by all the people that are here in service, the greeters, the musicians, the people who make sure that we're being fed, and for all of you who bring your own unique light to this space, to to uplift and support each person here. And so I know that also each person that has been placed on this whiteboard is blessed from the love that's being sent to them from everybody in this room. And I claim that that love goes out to David, to Evan, to Maria, to Don and Deb, to all families, to Kay, to Sharon, to Lyle, to Sherry, to David, to Caitlin and family, to Colton, to CSL Grand Junction, to the T-Day family, to Mary, Ken, Forrest, Anya, and Shannon, to Clint and Susanna, to Jason, Janet, Paul, Delilah and Jim, to Gabe, Madeline, Tally, and Susan, to the Comstock family, the Haas family, the Griggs family, and the Kelly family, to Tamara and Wally, Mike B, Jim, Chris J, Bill, and Marianne. I know that each of these beings are divinely blessed, and they feel the love of Spirit uplifting them and holding them in the most sacred place. And so for this beautiful day and this service, I am so grateful. I know that each person here shines their light in such a beautiful way into this community and out into the world, causing a ripple of love to reach so many people. And so from this place of deep, deep gratitude, I just release my word to the law. I let it go. I let it be. And together we say,
and so it is.
Get ready, my soul. I'm diving in. Get ready, my soul. I'm diving in to the deepest. To the sweetest kind of life. Get ready, get ready, my soul. 'Cause here I go. Get ready.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It's so exciting to be on this side of everything and getting to look out and see all of you beautiful lights that are out there. Reverend Anna and I have been so excited to be here today and to be able to represent CSL Grand Junction and share our being in service with you guys, as Brenda and Lou are down there sharing their lights with our community. So this is a real gift, and I hope it's something that occasionally we will be able to do and to be able to support both communities in this way. Please know that the prayer chest, as always, is open today. And if you have any requests for practitioner support, that will still be available, whether you're celebrating something that you want to celebrate and have somebody celebrating with you, or you're having a challenge and would like to be uplifted. Please fill out a prayer request. It will be held in confidentiality and it will be prayed on all week long. So I invite you to do that. My first reading today is by a woman named Tasha Silver, who's a spiritual writer and speaker. Divine Order says that the perfect solution to any problem is already selected if you allow yourself to be guided. Divine Source says there's a natural universal abundance that knows how to meet every need. Harmonizing with this force of love is the golden key to everything. And then from Ernest Holmes, your endeavor is not so much to find God as it is to realize God's presence and to understand that this presence is always with you. Nothing can be nearer to you than that which is the very essence of your being.
Well, Brenda is with us in this sense that she requested that I send this song to her. Different clothing, different colors, different names. But different is only dangerous when we forget that in the heart we're all the same. And we'll remember once we close our eyes to see at such distances we're never meant to be. Call it God, call it Spirit, call it Jesus, call it Lord, call it Buddha, Baha'u'llah, Hashem, or Heaven's Door. It's Muhammad, it's your mind, it's your soul, or it's your sign. It's the universe, it's music, Mother Earth or Father Time. But whatever name you give it, it's all one power, can't you see? And whatever name you give it, it's the very air we breathe. It's the power of the love. You and me, one power. One power. One power. One power. It's what we are. It's the moment of creation. It's an everlasting peace. It's the freedom of forgiveness. The sweetness of release. It's the joy of inspiration. It's the sunshine on your face. It's the birthright of all nations, the boundlessness of space. It's the beauty of a baby, the serenity of sleep. It's the anger we abandon, for it's love that's most deep. It's one power. It's the power of the love that lives forever in you and me. It's the power of the love in you and me.
To Reverend Anna Scott from CSL Grand Junction. We're happy to have you.
Hello.
Hello.
I just want to look around and take in the love. Some of you I've known for a long time, and some of you I don't know at all. But at any rate, it is so, so good to be here. I am so grateful for this opportunity and for the idea that Brenda had of let's swap pulpits and see what happens. This may be my first and last time here, I don't know. But I'm just so grateful for the love that our communities have shared over the years. If you've been here a very long time, you may remember that I served as a practitioner here about 2007 for a couple years and under Reverend Kay Spinden, and what a blessing that was. And I trust that today Brenda and Roy and Lou are having a great time down at CSL Grand Junction, and that everything is just going great. So Brenda and I gave each other ideas of what the talk title could be, should be. Now I gave her an option. Did she give me an option? No. She asked me to speak about, what is it about Science of Mind that I love? What is it that I love? What has brought this into my life in such a passionate way? There are so many things I could talk about. How much time do we have? You know, I might talk about understanding human behavior. I might talk about how this teaching has helped me come into contact and knowledge of my own behavior, and honestly, why I act the way I do. Yeah, or I might talk about how this teaching has helped me understand a little about the behavior of other people. Yeah, and why they act the way they do. I might talk about metaphysics, this science that is what Science of Mind is, the science that studies the fundamental nature of reality, the nature of being, how we are spiritual beings having a human experience. I might talk about how Science of Mind has promoted in me a new level of self-awareness and an ability to empathize with others. I might talk about how it has improved my mental health, believe it or not, and I just have learned so many strategies to calm the mind, calm the body, that has really helped me find a place of peace within. Yeah. I might talk about how Science of Mind has taught me how to open and use my imagination. And I love this quote by Einstein that says, logic will get you from point A to point B. Imagination will take you everywhere. Yeah, so in this teaching, we become more open to new things. I love that Science of Mind studies deep questions. Questions like consciousness, a nature of reality. The whole idea of oneness and how miraculous and wonderful and loving that is. I might talk about how Science of Mind promotes peace in the world. And I might talk about how, beyond all of these wonderful things, Science of Mind gives us a practical way to create a relationship within us with our Creator. I just think it is so exciting to find that we have a direct line to Spirit. You know, I came into this teaching around 1990 at what was called then the Church of Religious Science in Grand Junction, and it was a different me back then. I was pretty ragged and had spent a lot of time drinking and doing drugs, and was so grateful to find that community. And it's so interesting how that happened. First, I think maybe I should tell you, what is my talk title today? So the talk title is, It's a New Dawn. It's a New Dawn. And that comes from a song that was, I'm not quite sure if it was written by Nina Simone. It seems like there are all sorts of varying interpretations of whether it's Nina Simone wrote it or just sang it. But anyway, the song goes, it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Yeah, so I chose that title because this life that I have since I came into Science Mind is a new life. It is wonderful. It is a new day, and I am feeling good. You know, what Science of Mind has done for me is to allow me to use that power that is greater than I am. Use that power that is greater than I am to create freedom in my life, to liberate myself from oppression. I believe that Science of Mind and Spirit is the greatest philosophy ever. I have studied this now for 30 plus years and still feel like I'm a beginner. There's still so much to learn. So back in the day, around before 1990, I used to hang out at a bar all the time in Grand Junction, and there was this guy, Dave, that used to come there every Wednesday night after his choir practice at this church, the Religious Science Church. And he kept asking my brother and I to go to this church. Well, we didn't want to go to any stupid church. You know, church was for weak people. Church was for people that had to cling on to something. Now, what is alcohol and drugs for? Well, anyway, so Dave, God bless him. I don't really know where he is today, but if he's anywhere, his name's David Palmer. If you ever happen to run into him, tell him I say thank you for being so persistent, because he asked us every Wednesday night for probably 2 years, and finally we went to the Christmas Eve service at that church at the time. And that minister said, God is in you. And I thought, you don't know who I am. God is not in me. And there was something, though, that night. There was a feeling, a sense, a knowing that I would be back. Now, it took me a couple years to get back, but once I got back, I was ready. I started to come on a regular basis, and I learned a new concept of God that really made sense to me. A God that was loving, a God that was for me, not against me. I learned that God is not a person, but a presence personified in us. That God is everywhere present, all-knowing, all-powerful. And mostly, indeed, I learned that God is in me, and in you, and in you, and in all of us. So, you know, I started taking classes back then, and I thought, yeah, I'll take classes and I can learn what religious science is all about. But what did I really learn? I really learned what I am all about. Yeah. You know, one of the first exercises in those classes, I don't think it's part of it now, but anyway, back then it was. You took this 24-hour period and you just had a little tally sheet and marked down every time you had a positive thought, a negative thought, or neutral thought. Well, I was quite surprised to look at my sheet at the end of that period. It looked rather negative. So through that exercise, I began to do what? Change my thinking, change my life. There's this guy, William Bridges, that said, transition always begins with an ending. To become something else, you have to stop being what you are now. To start doing things in a new way, you have to end the way you're doing them now. And to develop a new attitude or outlook, you have to let go of the old. So Science of Mind gave me that opportunity for a new life. I mentioned that exercise about tracking the thoughts. Yeah, so it was so shocking for me to see how my thoughts were directed. Then I was in the next class and I heard that we are responsible for our own lives. Oh my goodness, I was shocked and very dismayed. I was taught that the circumstances of your life, those are all things you've created. So I told the teacher, Dr. Carl Wahlberg, some people may remember him, I said, I don't want to be responsible for my life. I surely can't be responsible for this. And Carl said, well, okay, you can have till next week at class time, and then you can tell me who you want to make responsible for your life. Well, after contemplation, I realized I have to be responsible for my own life. Yeah. So I began to develop a spiritual practice, and I began to develop a relationship with God different than the one that I had previously. You know, some of you in this room may possibly remember that kind of a relationship where no need to talk to God until things have really gone to H-E-double-Q. Yeah. First, you should ask your mother, your brother, your sister, your hairdresser, the person at the grocery store. Ask everyone, but whatever you do, don't go within to that spirit that's in you. Well, I learned that there is a different way. That sacred presence is right here, within. Yeah, one of the most important things about this teaching that I love is that we are forgiven. There's nothing that we have ever done, ever could do, ever have done, ever will do, that can't be forgiven. You see, Spirit doesn't really need to forgive us anyway. Spirit doesn't judge us. So I've learned that there is that place within us that is pure and undamaged, just as it was created in the beginning. You know, and that we say that place is there. We don't know where there is, but there. It's not only there, it is who we are. It is the truth of who we are. Ernest Holmes says, "You may be sure of this. There is an integrity to your soul, such as you will find nowhere else in the universe." That's what I was after. I was ready to release all the guilt and remorse from my past life. I was ready to live in wholeness and joy. I was searching for inner peace. And at first, I felt like I was looking in all the wrong places. You know, mother, brother, sister, hairdresser. Yeah. Looking in the outer when the peace that I was looking for was really right here in me. I have found a deeper peace than I've ever had in my life. Now, I'm not saying that things don't come up now and then that kind of rock me. I don't mean like, but you know. We'll call them opportunities for growth. Yeah, it's a new dawn. Every day is a new experience, and who knows what might happen today. This teaching has given me so much. My self-respect, my feeling of self-worth, my feeling of belonging. Now I say the teaching has given me. Actually, I had to take these principles and practices into my own life and incorporate them. You know, sometimes we think about how am I going to do this, and we tell ourselves, I don't know how to do that. And Ernest Holmes assures us that we do know. There's something within us that does know. And one way that I found then and now that works for me is affirmations. Affirmations are just short present tense statements that affirm our good. And you know, sometimes when we're saying an affirmation, it just seems so far out of reach, like, this is just BS. But really, the more we say it, it creates a neural pathway in our brain, and then, believe it or not, we're doing it. Yeah, you know, everything is vibration. Everything is a vibration. We all vibrate at a certain level, some higher, some lower. And some days for us, it's higher, and some days for it, it's lower. Every thought we have emits a frequency to the universe, and this frequency returns to its origin. What was that about creating your own life, being responsible for your own life? What am I putting out? If you have thoughts of discouragement, of fear, of anger, of sadness, this is going to return. If you have thoughts of success, love, peace, happiness, abundance, that will come back to you. And the people that you hang out with will influence your vibration. So I would suggest that as much as we can, let's surround ourselves with happy, positive people that will help us lift our vibration. And also just the precious gift of gratitude. Gratitude opens the door for more good, more positive things in our life. And while all this is true, remember there's nothing outside of ourselves that we need. The potential for all is within us. Spirit waits on our welcome. Yeah, Spirit waits on our welcome. We are created to be free. And we have that option to listen to the inner voice or not. It works through our belief in it. So I love what Emma Curtis Hopkins says. She said that your mama can't eat your vegetables for you. Your mama can't eat your vegetables for you. In other words, nobody can know God for you except yourself. So through all my gaining of spiritual knowledge, I'm still peeling away layers of the onion. You know, back in the day, I thought that would end sometime. But here we are 30 years later, and man, that is a big onion. You know, there's a power in just being aware of what's going on. Just a simple awareness. Because until we're aware of something, we can't heal it. So here's where I'm going to be really honest with you. Preparing to come here, I started getting a little aware that I was very, very nervous. And I was thinking, why am I so nervous? I do this, I've done this every week for several years now, but you know, with my own little people that have heard my own little quirks and, you know, uniqueness. So I know that there is a tendency for me, and maybe for you, probably not, but for me, to want to go into that comfort zone, that place where I feel comfortable, that place that's familiar. So why do you suppose that I could have been feeling nervous? Could it be that habit that I developed so long ago that I thought I'd healed, that tells me that I'm not enough? Could it be that for a moment I forgot that we are all one? Could it be that I needed a reminder that I am, we are, all made of love? Did I forget for a moment that who I am matters? That who you are matters? We are all part of a beautiful puzzle, and each piece is important. Each one of us is divine. So the fortunate thing about this whole scene, remember how my mental health is improving? I was able to be the witness and see myself feeling this fear. I became aware of that emotion and I was able to explore it. And even though I still may be a little bit nervous right now, I know that I stand on a firm foundation of faith. I know that God is right here within me, within you, and this is a beautiful, loving group, and that all is well. What I know is that as our frequency changes, a new world will emerge. And our frequency changes as we see the good. We are invited to know that Spirit is for us, in us, through us, around us, and is us. We are a part of that one mind of Spirit. For all of us, it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, and we are feeling good.
Yay.
If you would please just join me in a spiritual mind treatment, our form of affirmative prayer. We just take a deep breath in, feeling that goodness, that peace of God, knowing that there is one infinite love intelligence, and it is everywhere, in everything, in every person, in every circumstance, always present, all-knowing, all-loving. And I know that that is the truth of who and what we are. We are divine emanations of that one mind, that one life. And so I claim for each one of us that today we make that choice of responsibility, that choice of love, that choice of knowing that God is right where we are, flowing through us, and God is always for us, always supporting us. I am so, so grateful for this precious teaching. I'm so grateful for this precious community and for this time that we have shared together today. I know good and only good for this center and for Center for Spiritual Living Grand Junction and everyone that will ever pass through these doors, that ever has passed through these doors, that ever will pass through these doors. All are blessed. So in a just a deep feeling of gratitude, of love, of peace, I say thank you, Spirit. I know that we are blessed and we are a blessing. I know that all is well. And I'm grateful for the good that we have now and all the good that is coming to us from so many different directions. I just release this word to the action of the law. I know it is done. I know it is complete. And together we say, and so it is.
God, you are every mountain. God, you are every ocean. God, you are every canyon, every inch of earth and sky. God, you are every morning. God, you are every midnight. God, you are every moment, every second of my life. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. God, you are every sunrise. God, you are every moon glow. God, you are every starshine, every inch of earth and sky. God, you are every springtime. God, you are every snowfall. God, you are every season, every second of my life. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Cause you are the very breath I breathe, and your perfect love created me. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below,
super duper. As the ushers come forward, this is our time to practice our law of intentional giving. And we have an affirmation. Am I on the right thing? Oh, he gave me the look, I thought. Okay, here we go.
That was the wrong look.
Okay, it was the wrong look, sorry. Divine love
in and through me blesses and multiplies my offering.
Take my
Welcome anyone who is here for the first time or someone we haven't seen in a long time. We're happy you're here, and after service we have fellowship downstairs to join us for a cup of tea or coffee and some great conversation. Tamara has the opportunity to take a credit or debit card, so if you need her, I like the finger up. I think that's more of an accurate representation. See? So if you need to pay for anything out of the bookstore, let us know. We will help you out. Again, don't forget about the prayer chest down the stairs to the left. Please leave your prayer requests with us. We might not have opened the bookstore, but we could open the bookstore. I know where the key is. I can open the bookstore. So if you need to be in the bookstore today, please do not delay. We will do that. Anything else? I think we got it all. All right. So let's work on claiming our good together here. We have this affirmation that we will read aloud together and go from there. So, you ready? All right.
God is life, and this life expresses through me as radiant health. God is love, and this love expresses through me as service to others. God is abundance, and this abundance is my supply. God is infinite intelligence, and this intelligence expresses through me as guidance.
And so it is.
I'm in the right place at the right time. I'm just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I'm just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I'm just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I'm just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I'm just where I'm supposed to be. Oh, my soul is welcome. I am.
affirmation to go. Ready?
I am unique and wonderful.